Hi guys, I've kept on having carbon buildup on this GDI engine, and although I've used some cleaners in the past with some success, the buildup just keeps on coming back. And so today I'm going to be installing an oil catch can to tackle this. I also had some interesting challenges along the way. Now let's get this. And here's what comes with the oil catch can that I chose. Good to see that this brand comes with O-rings for the inlet and outlet ports, as this minimizes vacuum leaks. It also comes with an optional drain tap, should you want to install that. The other thing you're going to need is an appropriate length of rubber hose for the inlet side of the catch can, as well as some Teflon tape. And here's why I'm doing this. You can see the level of buildup on the pistons, and some of this is definitely due to the oil vapors that are coming from the PCV system, which get recirculated into the intake manifold, where it forms deposits on the back of the intake valves, particularly on GDI engines. It also extends into the combustion chamber. The oil vapor acts as an impurity in the air-fuel mixture. An oil catch can mitigates this by incorporating a baffle plate inside of it, which helps to cool and condensate the oil before the cleaner air then passes through this filter to the intake manifold. On this 2017 Accord, I'll be installing the catch can on this bracket, which is mounted to the firewall on the intake side of the engine. The location on your engine might be different, but the most important thing is to choose an area that is away from the exhaust manifold or the other hotter areas in the engine. If it's installed in any of these hotter areas, the condensation of the oil will be limited and you won't get the best out of installing an oil catch can. And the bracket is out. I'll take off the two hex screws holding the mounting bracket to the oil catch can, and using this on the metal bracket, I'm able to mark out the exact points that I need to drill. Using a punch on the marked areas helps to create an indentation, which focuses the effort of the drill. And after some minutes of drilling, I finally have the two holes that I need. I actually broke two drill bits and learned some important lessons in this my first attempt of drilling metal. The first thing is that the shorter the bit, the lesser the chances of failure, and I probably didn't sit the bit all the way inside the drill chuck. And secondly, even if your drill bit fails, that's not the end of the world. I was still able to use this broken bit on the drill, and because it was shorter, I had less chances of it breaking. Next, I apply some silicone spray to deter rusting and mount the bracket for the oil catch can on the metal bracket. I also replace this clip for the fuel hose, and at this point had to file down the length of this particular screw since it had the risk of perforating the fuel line. Next, I prepared the oil catch can for mounting by installing the O-ring on the inlet and outlet fittings. In addition, to improve the vacuum seal, I also apply some Teflon tape to the threads of the fittings, and finally lightly loop the O-rings on the fittings before screwing them into the oil catch can. I finish up by tightening with a size 17 wrench. No crazy torque, the O-ring is going to do the work. Be sure to do the same for the drain plug at the bottom, which uses a hexagonal bit. The Teflon tape is even more needed here since the plug doesn't come with an O-ring. We remount the metal bracket on the firewall, and then I bring in the oil catch can and secure it to its mounting bracket using the two small hex bolts. Next, I'll start by removing the hose clamp for the PCV hose and detaching the hose. Next, we take this new rubber tubing, which is going to take the former position of the PCV hose on the PCV valve, push that in and install the hose clamp. I cut the other end of this hose to an appropriate length and fit it to the inlet side of the catch can, while the original PCV hose, which comes with the car, goes into the outlet side of the catch can. Next, I used some zip ties to secure the hoses. I ended up not liking the hose clamps that I got for these, and so I'll replace the hose clamps later. Start the car and reset the trip meter. I'm going to be checking the level of oil collected in the catch can in the next 500 to 1000 miles. I also head over to the engine to listen for any hissing sounds from a vacuum leak. I don't hear any. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.